Look, there is no AI or quantum computing without gallium in the computer chips. LED lights don't exist without gallium. China controls 98%. So there is a need for a source outside of China.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Terrain Minerals Executive Director, Justin Virgin. Justin, very good to meet you. For viewers not familiar with the company, tell us a little bit about Terrain Minerals and what you do.
Yeah, thanks, Stephen. Great to be here. Terrain Minerals is a West Australian-based exploration company. So we're an explorer at heart, but it looks like we're onto a couple of very exciting opportunities. We're currently drilling 3,500 metres, 17 holes into our Monza Lightning project and a part of our Smokebush project. So we're following up some pretty exciting gold results there. We've been playing around here for 4 or 5 years now. We did an IP survey and we now think we're onto something. We're following up 11 metres at 6 grams and 43 grams silver at Lightning, and Monza's 700 metres long. Mineralised, we chased it down deep and got 5 metres at almost 4 grams. And they're two parallel structures sitting next to each other. And there's potential for a couple of more structures, which we'll be testing after the IP survey. We're starting to see things with the more data that we're putting in. And we've also chasing or advancing our Larin gallium project. It's at metallurgical studies at the moment that are getting run by Curtin University. So there's two key projects and we generate projects as well.
So with the Monza and Lightning prospects, Justin, tell us about the prospects that you're seeing there, the potential for those.
We're really excited. Monza looks like it's just a traditional gold in structure, where Lightning has got a bit of a VMS smelt about it. We've got Golden Grove to our north, which is an old historic mine still going. Started out as a gold project, now multi-element. And Capricorn Metals Mount Gibson project to our south. So we're in VMS territory. Lightning was only discovered because we couldn't quite figure out some of the influences we're seeing at Monza drilling. And bang, right next to it, there's this big IP sulfide anomaly. So this is could be something quite special. And we're this drilling program is going to be a cracker with 17 holes. I think there's been a lot of positive news coming out. We're drilling today. So
you mentioned the Golden Gallium project, Justin. Could you maybe tell us more about that and also gallium and why that's significant?
Yeah, at Larin's Lame, it's about 5-6 k's away from where we're drilling at Lightning and Monza at Smokebush. It's an interesting one. We've got gallium in sand or in clay. It's in a regolith. It's sitting in a drainage channel, which between two granites, they sort of come up like that. There's a big long laneway, which is 3 k's by 9 k's, and I think it may get bigger. We have a JORC exploration target on 5% of the target area from surface in many areas and up to 63 metres thick. So look, gallium is one of these, though it's a non-LME, it's a B2B sort of market, so it's unknown, but it's the glue that holds the world together. People don't really realise it. Gallium, look, there is no AI or quantum computing without gallium in the computer chips. LED lights don't exist without gallium. They're putting it in electric motors or magnet motors because it stabilises. It allows for faster switching at lower voltages at higher temperatures. So they're making gallium alloys. It's maybe 1 to 2,000 tonne a year. It's very small, but China controls 98%. So there is a need for a source outside of China. Typically, get extract from bauxite or aluminium mining, they get maybe 10-15% recoveries from what we're hearing. So we may have something very special here. Ours is associated with a rare earth. And there seems to be rare earth and gallium in contact. And then we get away from the contact up to the surface, the rare earth seems to disappear and we have more gallium. So this, 27 square Ks, there's potential for scale here on a big way. The area actually is a drainage channel that goes down to a river. So it's all oxidized and it's exciting. It's a bit of a frontier sort of stuff. We're looking for something else there. We've got 102 holes into it. And we found gallium. We're already on the gallium bandwagon from another project. So we knew about it and we just stumbled on it really. So we'll take it.
Justin, a more recent project added to the portfolio in Queensland, that's Billow Wheeler Copper and Gold. Tell us a little bit about that, please.
Our Billow Wheeler project is inland from Rockhampton. so north of Brisbane in Queensland, it was in Australia, obviously. That's a copper gold opportunity. It's got seven more cut targets. It's been held in one company for 15 years. And when they started dropping it, my geologist had association with this project and this other company. So they made discoveries elsewhere, never got to this. He left, they dropped it. And we've only just got it granted after a 2-year process, just north of the Cracow gold mine. But there's three or four different styles of mineralization reported independently on this area. We got rock chips up to 9% copper and 2 grams gold. And various other readings. I've walked parts of it. There's secondary copper hanging at the ground. So, it's come from somewhere. And it's an exciting opportunity to have. And, it's sitting in a major geological belt that potentially could house something significant. But a bit earlier, so it's the end of the year, we'll be there.
Justin, you're in the midst of a $1.8 million rights issue. Your board is backing this, they're participating. Tell us how that will help fund you to take these projects forward.
Yeah, we've had some pretty good support, and I believe it'll be well taken up. Look, I'm personally priority underwriting a portion of this and taking my rights up. Both other board members are taking their rights up as well and doing a little bit of underwriting. So it's basically to drive more drilling. So we're doing 3,500 meters, 17 holes at Monza and Lightning at Smokebush. We want to go straight back and do more drilling. I believe this will be warranted. Obviously, we need some good results, but from what we've seen to date, it's pretty exciting. And obviously, there's other projects need a bit of work. Larin's Lane doesn't really drag much cash out of us because it's currently metallurgical stage at the Curtin University, WA government-funded study. So it doesn't cost us too much. And Queensland, we're just getting there. So the bulk of these funds is more gold drilling. I think it's gold, 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 and gallium at train at the moment. And I'd love to keep that rig spinning until next year. And our gold project, we hope to have a resource sort of mid next year. I think this is the real deal. There's mills nearby, the Kirk Locker mills trying to restart. So we do have a potential milling solution without having to build something. So potentially quick cash flow.
Justin, I hope you'll keep us updated on progress on all of those fronts. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Thank you, Stephen. Much really appreciate the time.
Justin Virgin, Executive Director at Terrain Minerals.